Okay, now let us move to scenario 2. Look at this sentence. I have dash euro to spend on my lunch today. What do you think will come here? A or an? Did you say an? Sorry, it's incorrect. The correct article would be A. It is not the vowel or consonant, but their sound that matters in deciding which article is correct. Here, you sounds like U, Y-double-O, U. Now try this one. He works in dash university. I hope you are not tricked this time. It's again a. The sound of U is again U. So be careful with words which have U sound. They will not take an as an article. So the rule that we have learnt here is singular countable noun beginning with a consonant sound would take article A. Okay, try this one. There is a dash 8 in my phone number. 8 has a vowel sound and hence it would take an. Again, the emphasis should be put on the sound. Try this one. I got dash F in the quantitative techniques course. I'm sure you must have got it right. It sounds like F, E-F-F, and hence we would need an article an. So we have learnt singular countable nouns beginning with a vowel sound would take an. Look at this sentence. He has dash MBA but chooses to work as a farmer. So MBA would take an as it is pronounced as a series of letters. And M sounds like E-M, M. And hence we will need an as the article. I am dash NASA engineer. What do you think would come here? Good that you have not said an, as NASA is pronounced as a word and not as a series of letters. So we will have a NASA engineer and not an NASA engineer. So be careful to see if the abbreviation is pronounced as a series of letters or as a single word, means an acronym. This one is very simple. I found dash broken egg in the basket. What do you think would come here? Yes, it would take a. Though the article is used for egg, but the choice of article will depend on the sound of the word it precedes. And hence, it would take a. Now try this. This is dash unusual problem. You are aware of the U sound. Here, un is pronounced as un. So it will take article an. So please do not hold any assumptions. Treat each word in isolation and focus on what it sounds like. Okay, now let us move to scenario 3. Now let's see this one. Dash long reports are difficult to write. This is the case of countable unspecific plural nouns and it would not take any article as per our framework that we discussed in the last tutorial. Any and many reports can be long. We don't know anything about this report. Okay, now try this. Dash children are playing outside. Here again, this is the case of countable unspecific plural nouns. So again, this will not take any article.
I would like to caution you that these nouns can become specific provided they have a context. Let's say for an example, a husband comes back home and asks his wife where are Guddu and Guddi. The wife replies, the children are playing outside. Here the children are Guddu and Guddi, which makes children specific and hence would take the article the. So please be very careful before you zero in on your choice of article. So before you decide that a plural or uncountable noun will not take any article, please ensure that the context does not make them specific.
Okay, now let us move to scenario 4. Try these. She gives a good advice. Here, advice is uncountable. and you already know what would come here. Remember our framework? There would not be any article here. So the correct sentence would be, she gives good advice. Try one more. A homework takes a lot of my time. Here, homework is uncountable. It will not take any article. And the answer would be, homework takes a lot of my time.
I would again like to caution you here that though homework is uncountable and unspecific here, there may be a context where it can become specific. Let's say a child goes to school and when he comes back, he tells his mom, though he enjoyed the classes very much, the homework takes a lot of his time. Here, because of the context, homework became specific. So I'll again repeat. Before you decide that a plural or uncountable noun will not take any article, please ensure that the context does not make them specific.
Now, let's do a quick review of scenario 2, 3 and 4. Try these. I have dash MP3 player. Can you tell me what will come here, a or an? And also tell me why. Yes, we will have an here because MP3 is pronounced as a series of letters. Okay, now try this. I saw her coming with dash boy. Very simple. I don't think there is any confusion here. It will take the article A because it is a case of singular countable noun beginning with a consonant sound. Now try this. My friend is playing dash entrepreneur in dash TVF TV series. Here, the first blank would take an because entrepreneur has a vowel sound. And the blank before TVF would take a because TVF is pronounced as a series of letters. And T does not have a sound of vowel. Now, let's try this one.
It's dash nice day today.
Again, there is no confusion. Here, a noun day is modified by nice and the initial sound of nice
is that of a consonant.
So it would take a. Okay, try this one. I am looking for dash work. This was tricky. Work is uncountable noun. So we will not have any article here. Let us look at the final sentence now. Dash oranges are a good source of vitamin C. Again, what do you think would come here? This is the case of plural, countable and unspecific noun and hence it would not take any article. I hope by now you would be confident of your ability to determine if the given noun is specific and which article to use if it is not specific. And finally, today onwards, just do this small exercise for the sake of this time we are spending together learning English grammar. Whenever, wherever you encounter a single countable noun, just hold on for a second and ensure it is not standing alone. That is, without an article or a determiner. You will never mess it up. Good luck.